नमो नमः। विद्या नाम नरस्य रूपम अधिकम प्रच्छन्न गुप्तम धनम विद्या भोगकरी यशस्सुखकरी विद्या गुरुणाम गुरुः विद्या बंधुजनो विदेशगमने विद्या परादेवता विद्या राजसु पूज्यते न हि धनम विद्या विहीन पशुः। विद्या नाम नरस्य रूपम अधिकम। The Subhashitam says, Vidya or knowledge enhances the personality of a man. Prachanna guptam dhanam. It is a valuable treasure that must be kept well guarded and concealed. Vidya bhogakari, yashas sukhakari. It gives us glory and happiness. Vidya gurunam guruhu. It is the teacher of all teachers. Vidya bandhujano videsha gamane. It is our friend in a foreign land. Vidya paradevata. It is supreme divinity. Vidya rajasu pujyate nahi dhanam. The kings appreciate knowledge, not wealth. Vidya vihina pashuhu. One without knowledge lacks the sixth sense. An interesting story in Bhagavatam where Narad Muni narrates a story to King Prachina Barhis. It is the story of the city of nine gates. So there is this king, Puranjana, and his guardian, Avignata. So they are two inseparable friends. One day, Puranjana and Avignata, they see a city, a beautiful city. The city has nine gates. Puranjana is greatly attracted by the city. He's awestruck by the beauty of the city. The city is called Bhogavati. And there are nine gateways to the city. So he decides to go into the city. When he enters the city, he finds that there is a beautiful woman over there, perhaps the ruler of the city. She has 10 attendants walking around her, guarding her. And there is one huge serpent with 5 hoods, which is walking ahead of her. They are all guarding her as she is walking. So King Puranjana is awestruck by the beauty of the lady. And he prays to her, for her hand in marriage. So the lady agrees and they start to live together. Several years go by and the couple have several children, and many years go by. One day a certain enemy attacks the city of Bhogavati. So the enemy comes with his army of 360 men. They surround the city of Bhogavati. And Kal and Jara, two other people, also attack the city of Bhogavati. So Puranjana is he tries to put up an attack. Both the city of Bhogavati tries to fight the enemies, but the enemy proves to be too powerful. Kal and Jara are too powerful for the city of Bhogavati, and the army of 360 men also proved to be too powerful, and eventually one day the city of Bhogavati just falls to the ground. Now Puranjana, who's living inside the city, also he's stunned by what he's seeing. He doesn't know what to do. The 5-hooded serpent, which is supposed to be the guardians, the 10 attendants, the guardians, what happened? They are not able to protect the city of Bhogavati. So the city of Bhogavati has just crumbled and fallen to the ground. So Puranjana does not know what to do. He begins to cry. He's so involved in the city. He has become one with the city. He's unable to withdraw himself from the material pleasures that the city, the beautiful city of Bhogavati and his wife have been giving him. But now the city is not there anymore. It is crumbled. So that is when his guardian Avignata, he appears. Then Puranjana says, "Where have you been?" Avignata says, "No, I have always been with you. It's just that you were so so engrossed in your household and in enjoying the beautiful city of Bhogavati that you forgot me. I've always been there, but you forgot to see me." Then Puranjana begs to Avignata and he says, no, please, I don't know what to do. The city doesn't exist anymore. My wife, everybody is dead. So please take me back. So Avignata takes Puranjana back. He says, don't worry. Come with me. Come, let's go back. We were together, remember? We were one with each other. So I will take you with me. Become one with me. Come, let's go back to the blessed lake where we were. Floating on the water. And so Avignata takes away Puranjana. So what is the underlying truth behind the story? So Bhogavati is nothing. The city of Bhogavati is nothing but the body. And the nine gateways are nothing but the nine orifices in the body. And Puranjana is actually the soul, the Atma, who enters Bhogavati, the body. And the five-hooded serpent is nothing but the prana and the five layers of prana, which sort of support the body, the city of Bhogavati. And the 10 attendants are the 10 Jnanendriya and Karmendriya, the senses that absorb the pleasures of the material world. So these are the guardians, no? The Jnanendriya, the Karmendriya and the prana. These are the things that keep the body going. So that was Bhogavati, and Puranjana is the Atma, and the army of 360 people who are surrounding, that indicates that is symbolic of the years that were rolling by. And so were Kal and Jara. Kal is time and Jara is old age. They were entering the body. They were trying to attack the body, the city of Bhogavati, which is the body. So that is why one fine day. So metaphorically, what is being said here is, the body into which the soul is trapped, the soul has become so one with the body, enjoying the material pleasures, absorbing, soaking in the ecosystem full of desires. The Atma has, the soul has become one with the body. But one fine day, Kal, Jara will attack the body and the body will fall to the ground. And the Atma does not know what to do. The Atma is really suffering. And that is when the Paramatma or the Avignata, the friend of Puranjana, remember, the guardian of Puranjana, Avignata comes into the picture and he says, I have always been there. It's just that you were so involved with the city of Bhogavati, with your body, that you forgot my existence. So come with me. The ultimate goal is to merge with me. Let us be together. We have to be in unison. That is supreme bliss. And that is Brahma Vidya. The one who knows this has truly acquired Brahma Vidya. The one who knows Brahma Vidya is enlightened. So, Vidya Nama Narasya Rupam Adhikam. So, Brahma Vidya will really enhance the personality of man, and it is Brahma Vidya that will enlighten man. Namo Namaha.